Let me introduce to you a patient, a boy at the age of 3. One day, he started grunting at his peers and parents for no apparent reason. This was quite unusual for him because he was rather a shy personality. At first, his parents thought, it's just normal, it's a part of his development. But soon after, he also began to start screaming for hours, as if in pain. When he wasn't screaming, he stared vacantly into space. He became depressive and suicidal at the age of 5. Terrifying thoughts of death plagued him. Whenever the word death came into his head, he smashed his head into windows and glass in order to drown out his thoughts. He couldn't go to the bathroom alone anymore because of the voices he heard and the things he saw in his head. Fear became immense and paralyzing. Over a course of 4 years, 100 doctors and a host of misdiagnoses and mistreatments, the parents tried to make peace with the idea that their son might never come back. Now, misdiagnoses are the blind spot in medicine, and they have been for decades. In fact, 1 in 7 diagnoses are misdiagnoses. Each year, 1.5 million lives could be saved with the right diagnosis. But what causes misdiagnoses? It's misinformation. Physicians have to consider more than 20,000 diseases at once, and this is more than they can handle. So, what can we do about it? The medical knowledge has already been published, but it's really hard to actually retrieve the right data in a timely manner. You could go to a specialist, but they're specialized on in few diseases only. You could also try to memorize all 20,000 diseases with their millions of connections to symptoms, signs, and statistics. Good luck with that. And there are already great approaches out there. Companies have tried to establish so-called symptom checkers since the 1970s. However, their databases are by far too small in order to provide any sufficient accuracy. And furthermore, their results are sorted often by the alphabet. So there's no help here for the physician either. We have developed Symptoma, a search engine for diseases. Physicians enter symptoms, birth year and sex, and they receive a list of matching causes, sorted by the probability for the specific case, according to our database. Now, this is high technology. We have invested 7 years in research and development, and so far, we have established the probably biggest disease database in the world, with 20,000 diseases and millions of connections to symptoms, signs, and statistics. Our proprietary algorithm delivers the results in a smart way so that the physician can actually handle and process the information. Now, back then, when we started, experts told us it's impossible to overcome this kind of technology. And they referenced that since the 1970s, companies have tried to do it and failed at it, including companies such as Google or IBM Watson, who are still trying it. Now, we made back then a conscious decision that failure is not an option and we have to succeed because there's too much at stake here. And we did it. After 7 years, leading experts and even the European Commission acknowledge Symptoma as one of the best and most promising digital solution in healthcare. So back to our patient. By chance and luck alone, they came across a piece of crucial information that his condition might be the diagnosis called PANDAS, a rare autoimmune disorder. The treatment, a simple antibiotic. The results, dramatic. Within days, his fears vanished, and he smiled again for the first time in nearly 4 years. Within weeks, all his remaining symptoms just faded away. He returned out of the blue after being 4 years in the dark. Despite all the efforts of his parents, his many physicians, and all the technologies available at that time, they couldn't arrive earlier at this little crucial piece of information that would cure him. This patient was yet lucky, because each year, 1.5 million lives could be saved with the right diagnosis. This is what we are fighting for at Symptoma. Symptoma empowers physicians to diagnose even rare diseases they haven't even heard of before. It's all about providing the crucial piece of information at the right time. So in future, we will diagnose even rare diseases within minutes or days instead of years. But technologies aren't going to cut it, at least not alone. We need a new set of mind in order to overcome misdiagnoses. We have to acknowledge that physicians are not almighty. Physicians are human, and to err is human. Unfortunately, in healthcare, errors cost lives. So we have to provide physicians and patients alike all the resources, security, time, and tools in order to measure and improve diagnostic quality. So let's join us and join forces and pool our knowledge in order to overcome this challenge. If you want to help to saving lives of 1.5 million people each year, share this story, share this video right now. If you are a patient having already experienced a rare disease, share your story with me and we validate it within our database. If you are a doctor and an expert in a specific disease, come and contribute your further knowledge in order to help other doctors and patients to profit from it. Improving diagnostic quality now is not only possible, but it represents a moral, professional, and public imperative. Thank you.